This copying overhead that we're talking about in this client-server interaction and RPC call is a serious concern in RPC design. Why? Because this copying happens every time you have a call return between the client and the server. And so if there is a place where we want to focus on shaving overheads, it'll be on avoiding copying multiple times between the client and the server in order to make the RPC calls efficient. And if you go back to this analogy of a procedure call, the nice thing about this is that the arguments are set up in the stack, and that might involve some data movement, but there is not kernel involvement in the data movement, and that's what we would like to be able to accomplish in the RPC world as well. And in fact, let's analyze how many times copying happens in the RPC system. Recall that in an RPC system, the kernel has no idea of the syntax and semantics of the arguments that are passed between the client and the server. But yet, the kernel has to be the intermediary in arranging this rendezvous between the client and the server. And therefore, what happens in the RPC system is that when a client makes a call, there is an entity that is called the client stub. And what the client stub is going to do is, the client is thinking that it's making a normal procedure call, but it is a remote procedure call. And the client stub knows that. And what it does is it takes the arguments that is in the client call, which is living on the stack of the client, and makes an RPC packet out of it. This RPC packet is essentially serializing the data structures that are being passed as arguments by the client into a sequence of bytes. It's sort of like herding cats into an enclosed space. So that's what is happening by the client stub, taking the arguments that are on the stack of the client and creating a packet of contiguous bytes, which is the RPC message. Because that is the only way the client can actually communicate this information to the kernel. So this is the first copy that's happening from the client stack into creating this RPC message is the first copy that's happening even before the kernel is involved in this client-server interchange. The next thing that happens, the client traps into the kernel, and the kernel says, well, you know, there is a message which is the RPC message that has to be communicated to the server, and that's sitting in the user address space. I better copy it into my kernel buffer. So that's the second copy that's happening. From the address space of the client, this RPC message is copied into the kernel buffer. So that's the second copy. Next, the kernel schedules the server in the server domain because the server has to execute this procedure. So once that server has been scheduled, the kernel copies the buffer. It has all the arguments packaged in into the server domain. So that is the third copy that's happening. So we went from the client stack to the RPC message first copy, from the RPC message to the kernel buffer second copy, and now the kernel buffer is passed out to the server domain. That's the third copy. But unfortunately, even though we've reached the address space of the server procedure cannot access this because from the point of view of the procedure called semantics, the client and the server think that they are just doing a procedure call. So the server procedure is expecting all of the arguments in the original form on the stack of the server. And that's where the server stub comes in. So what the server stub is, just like the client stub, the server stub is a piece of code that is part of the RPC infrastructure that understands the syntax and semantics of the client-server communication for this particular RPC call, and therefore it can take this information that is now being passed into the server's address space by the kernel and structure it into the set of actual parameters that the procedure, the server procedure, is expecting. So this, from the server domain, wherever the kernel put it, into the stack of the server for the server procedure to execute that procedure, that's the fourth copy. So you can see that just going from the client to the server, there are four copies involved. These two copies are at the user level, and these two copies are what the kernel is doing in order to protect itself and the address spaces from one another by buffering the address space contents into kernel buffer and passing that to the server domain before the server domain can start using it in the form of actual parameters on the stack. So at this point, the server can start executing, the server procedure can start executing, do its job. When it is done, it has to do exactly the same thing in order to pass the results back to the client. So it is going to go through four copies, except that we're going to reverse it. We're going to start from the server stack and go all the way down to getting the information to the client stack in order for that exchange to happen. So in other words, with a client-server RPC call on the same machine with the kernel involvement in this process, there's going to be four copies each way. Going from the client to the server, there's four copies. Going from the server back to the client, there's going to be four copies. Two copies are happening in the user space, and two copies are happening in the kernel space, or orchestrated by the kernel, and two copies orchestrated at the user level. Now, as you can see, this is a huge, huge overhead compared to a simple procedure call that I showed you early on.